You know, I've been away from home for such a long time that I'd almost begun to look upon myself as someone who didn't belong anywhere anymore. For the last few weeks, I've been wearing an Australian uniform, and it gives me infinite satisfaction. Even if it's astonishing to find myself, an older lady of casual and undisciplined habits, suddenly buttoned up in a khaki tunic with a peaked cap and three pips on the shoulder, and sent to an airfield to paint a bomber crew. Their leave had been stopped, but they hadn't been told why. They were pretty sore until they found that their picture was for the Australian War Museum, and that they couldn't have been chosen for any but the most flattering reasons. And then they were fearfully pleased. Goodness, they were a tough-looking lot. Smooth, hard cheeks, craggy chins, and clear, keen eyes. They talked about Australia, and they said things like dinkum and bonza, and too right. That made me feel homesick, and it took me back across all the years to a time when my one idea was to get away to England. I thought Australia was a backwater, and I wanted at all costs to get into the mainstream, which of course meant Europe. It's different now, because the war has become the mainstream, and we're all in it, and it's flowing right around the earth. But in those days, it was inevitable that we should feel the glamour of the old world and come over here in search of art and wisdom. And it got me thinking of Ford and how he was a soldier in the war to end all wars.
It started with dreams. how is a man to penetrate the layers of protection that dear England gives to men of cloth and upper class selection? In cozy little England, where the middle class grows savage, Mother England weeps. When they all aim to be so average, hunting, fishing, shooting are prized arts of her elites. Their ideas of beauty page three girls from Fleet Street. Mother's favourites are financiers, the school tie, the decent club. But if you're in the arts, you're doomed. And that's the rub.
Cheer up, Captain Ford. You're the toast of London's literary circles. I thought your books were selling well. Almost as good as your missus's soapies. My girl can't wait for the next Violet Hunt romance.
Oh, she writes about romance, all right. That's just the trouble. It's all fiction to her.
Here, you're a rough one, Captain.
Girls, they come and go. I need someone fresh.
Sir, you always seem to have such luck with the ladies.
It's not luck I want. It's choice, lad.
Pour moi, Stella.
Oh, yes, Violet. Oh. You've kindly given me your novels. How I wish I could write. This is a painting of a teapot I did in Adelaide years ago.
Oh, what a treasure. Your teacher...
Margaret Preston.
Yes, well, she taught you well. Oh,
but I have so much to learn.
If only we could turn back the clock, get out of this ruddy mud and back to civilized life.
You know, I like it out here. Soldiers together.
At least us men understand each other.
At least we girls understand each other.
Men, what is this mad dash to be heroes? All the beastly carnage.
Well, you don't see any of that if you live in the right part of London. And Stella, darling, when it comes to living in London, there is only one truism. Location.
The market works on location. But I'd rather go for sensation. The corsets and stays to keep women proper. I checked out the window, I'm not come proper. If they're racy or rich, I don't care if they're young, or married or vain, or afraid of the dark, I beg them not wed them as free as a lark. And what is all of these things and much more? I've said to the world, I'm his wife, not his whore. Is amicus feelings we've put in our novels of wheelings and dealings. The market works on location, but I'd rather go for sensation. Ambition and lust, connections and style. As the clock ticks, 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 I smile, yes, I smile.
Violet, you are amazing. Lucky Ford. Tell me, you've lived with him for 8 years. I've read all his poetry and novels, but what is he really like?
could write about anything at all. We've even written books together. He wastes his talent, but he's charismatic, acrobatic, effervescent, quite depressant, a conundrum, nothing wrong, so endearing, so confusing, he's a lover,
behind those white notes. But women today, well, what can I say? They take their chances at slight little glances. They make advances, love your romances. They fancy their chances to raise all our lances, our lances. They tempt us at the dancers to get in our dances. Oh, women today.
There's somebody I'd like to
meet.
Because we are stars.
Highness.
Who, me?
Perchance would you like to dance? Perchance would you like to dance? I've the pictures to paint with words to foretell the kingdom I've planned for Stella. Perfume my cottage for you.
But you'll bring it with roses and sweet peas too.
Home from chickens, a ducks and a drake, pigs in the sty.
What a feast day we'll make.
My living hourglass. Thank you.
Suffocate, can't breathe. I must write to purge out demons that writhe and seethe. Yes, words help decant them, can't stop now. I have to finish each pen stroke, tiny markings. Helping my fizz diminish. A clear conscience, a soft pillow, the truth I must suppress. Talent lies untapped, you see. But I need her for my success. Without writing, I'm overwhelmed. Suffocate, can't breathe. I must write to purge out demons that writhe and seethe. Yes, words help decant them, can't stop now. I have to finish each pen stroke, tiny markings. Helping my fears diminish. A clear conscience, a soft If you'd leave me alone 5 minutes, maybe I could.
That is unfair. When I do everything for you. When was the last time I had 5 minutes to paint?
I'm drowning in medical commas and grammar.
My juggling textile and design to make glamour.
Form and illusion and simile too.
Perspective and shadow to name just a few.
I'm drowning in metaphor, commas and grammar.
I'm juggling and sextant
and
trying to make grammar.
Form and illusion and simile to
perspective and a shadow to a name just a few.
And washing your clothes.
I was drawing metaphor, commas and grammar. I'm
juggling and sextant and trying to make grammar. Perspective and a shadow.
Perspective and glamour to name just a few. Whatever an art form of family does know,
when it says without friends,
the clock is our foe. It ticks every time we want for ourselves. Our domestic tyrant, the clock on the shelf.
Thank you. Thank you. Chatting at me.
exposed to the critics.
Sharks smelling your feet, doubting one's own talent compared with one's peers. Feeling a failure while loading your latest. We'd stop if we could.
Oh! With the morals you may rule.
Left Papa in 1928 when he had finished his affair with Jean and gone to America. Mother threw herself into painting, and we managed somehow in Paris until the Depression made it too hard. Most of the expats went back to the States. We moved to London. I hardly knew a word of English. Dear Mummy found portrait and teaching work to support us. She even became an art critic with the pen name Palette. Daddy tried to make a living in the US. He's had other affairs too. But he's met another painter, Janice Biala, and he's settled since then. He loves artistic women. At least for a while. Lucky Papa. Janice devotes herself totally to him. Like they all did. Daddy's been ill, and they've come back to France. But now Daddy Dearest has telexed us with the most dreadful news. I hope the doctors are wrong.
Ford,
can I come in today?
Into the trenches, men! Fix bayonets! He's coming! Behold, the King of Shadows cometh!
Mother! You know he doesn't want you to see him like this.
Please, Julie. Ford! Ford, do you hear me?
Take cover, miss.
Let me see.
There's a sniper.
Garden indeed. All gone to weed. Great writer and fame. I fell in love with your words before I knew you.
How many homes did we make you?
Thank you. basket. You've stolen my prize. You promised the world not this trouble and strife. You twister, you liar, you sponger, you cat, damn you to hell for the pain that I felt. So much for the teapot full of sherry. Would you like it sweet, dear, one lump or two? Or will it be violet or jean or who? Oh, how special and how refined we are. The cream of the art world, destined to go far. How can you leave me, Stella, your star? I adored you forever, wide, deep, and far. Still long to touch you and bid you adieu. You were selfish to the very core. I hate you.
Hold me. I feel so cold.
Thank you. lady. You're a real painter.
Not just a lady painter.
When we get back from this flight, we'll sit for you again.
Yeah, be great for the folks back home to see us all kitted up.
Hey, Captain Bowen, that painting you did of our plane, it's bonza.
Yeah, too right.
The hour before dawn is the coldest, the darkest time of the night, when shadows and memories linger, waking my dreams take flight into the winds on shadows.
Thank you.